Andy, Mateo, Mr. Domínguez, Anthony, Jennifer, Johan, Pamela, Daniel, okay, Anthony, Catherine. Welcome to class. Some students I could see, more people are joining into the class. Welcome. Today we are going to finish the unit. Okay, we are going to work. We are going to work in the book and we are going to finish the unit number 6. We are going to do an activity from 4 until 5. Then you have to do a class participation in the ABAC. And tomorrow, Wednesday, you will take the test. Okay, so let me share the book. Just give me a second. Yeah, so we are going to practice comparatives and superlatives. Comparatives and superlatives, my dear students. We did, I explained it very clearly the last class. But anyway, here we have to complete in the book. Okay, remember when to use as, adjective, as good as, we use to compare something that is similar. Equal, okay? This is longer comparative for short adjectives. The best is superlatives. Okay, I want you to do this activity. Read carefully the information that you have in the page. Clase recién. Ok, ya, my dear students. So, do the activity. I check in 4 minutes. Thank you.
Teacher, no se escucha.
I repeat, I'm sorry.
Track 2.31. 1. Japan has by far the highest number of vending machines per person in the world. 2. It's much cheaper for sellers to run a vending machine than a shop. 3. But is curry and rice from a machine as good as curry and rice from a restaurant? 4. It's taking a bit longer than I imagined. 5. It's actually much better than I expected. 6. I think it might be the best vending machine meal I've ever eaten.
Listen again, please.
Track 2.31. 1. Japan has by far the highest number of vending machines per person in the world. 2. It's much cheaper for sellers to run a vending machine than a shop. 3. But is curry and rice from a machine as good as curry and rice from a restaurant? 4. It's taking a bit longer than I imagined. 5. It's actually much better than I expected. 6. I think it might be the best vending machine meal I've ever eaten.
Okay, please check your answers with the answers of the book, please. Number one, Japan has by far the highest number of vending machines. Number two, it is much cheaper for sellers to run a vending machine than a shop. Number three, but is curry and rice from a machine as good as curry and rice from a restaurant? Number four, it's taking a bit longer than I imagined. And finally, number five, it's actually much better than I expected. And finally, number six, I think it might be the best vending machine I have ever eaten. Okay, I explained to you carefully what is the way of comparing and making superlatives, but today we are going to check the grammar part on page 142. Wait a second, 142, okay? It is lesson B, yeah? This is a summary of what I said about comparatives. Please, we are going to make a review. In this part, we have the grammar rules for the comparatives and for making superlatives. Okay, for example, here says adjectives. One syllable, rich, richer, the richest. This is comparative and superlative. Adverbs, we have one example, fast, faster, the fastest, okay? Adjectives that ends in Y, for example, easy, easier is the comparative, the superlative is the easiest. Friendly, the comparative is friendlier, the superlative, the friendliest. Here we have, for example, often, that is an adverb. More often, the most often. We also have carefully, more carefully, the most carefully. Here we have careful, more careful, the most careful. Exceptions, I told you, good, better, the best. Bad, worse, the worst. Far, farther, the farthest. More, okay, more, you can say with bored, more bored for comparative. For superlative, the most bored. More tired, for superlative, the most tired. The same with ill, more ill, okay, the most ill. Then here we have clever, You can say cleverer, the comparative, and the cleverest, superlative. Here we have some adverbs. Well is an adverb. The comparative of well, better. The superlative, the best. Badly, worse. The superlative, the worst. Far, farther, the farthest. Early, earlier, the earliest. Okay? Some two-syllable adjectives can follow the rules for one syllable. Like, for example, clever, narrow, shallow, white, and simple. Okay? What else about comparatives? More information here, comparisons. We can use comparative adjectives and adverbs to compare two things, situations, times, actions, okay? Normally you use than. We can change the degree of comparisons with words like a lot, much, far, even, slightly, a bit, a little. For example, life is a lot more interesting than before. She is a bit happier than she used to be. Okay? Let me make bigger because I don't see. Yeah. He is speaking much more slowly than usually today. Than usual today, sorry. Okay? Then here we have more information about comparatives. The opposite of more, please pay attention. The opposite of more is less. We can use it with all the adjectives and adverbs, okay? The car is slightly clean than it was. I drive less quick than he does. Don't forget, more is the opposite of less, okay? As adjective or adverb, okay? As shows that two things are equal, yeah? They are as wealthy as the royal family. She doesn't listen as carefully as she should. Okay? And finally, for extremes, we use superlative adjectives and adverbs to talk about extremes. It is the worst hotel in the world. I got the lowest score possible. We often use the present perfect with ever with superlatives. This is the best meal I have ever eaten. All of this information, guys, I said in the slides, in the PowerPoint presentation that we were checking the last class. So this is not new for you. This is not new for you, okay? I'm going to continue with extra practice, okay? Go to the page number here. Modals. No, wait a second. Yeah. Here, my dear students, comparatives and superlatives. We are going to do only the letter A and B for extra practice because we did this in the other class, in the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so for extra practice, you are going to do, but fast because you did it, the letter A and the letter, first the letter A, okay? I check the activity in 3 minutes. Do it. Thank you. Okay, guys, let's check the activity in the number one. It is an example. Indian food is spicier than French food. Number two, please, Andy. This is
the most delicious.
Perfect. The most delicious meal I have ever eaten. Number three, please, Jacob.
Tell me, teacher.
Number three, please.
The weather was hotter than I expected.
Hotter than. Hotter than I expected. Thanks, Jacob. Michelle. Number four.
She is a slower driver than me.
Perfect. Thank you. Next, please, Cesar. Number five. Are you
the cleverest person in your class?
Perfect. Thank you. Luis, the next. I didn't have a good holiday. I think he didn't listen. Mateo Leiva, please. Number six.
Worst.
I didn't have a good holiday. The worst thing was the hotel. It was terrible. Thank you. Lenin Kaisa, finish the activity, please. Number seven.
Your English is better than.
Perfect. Luis Pozo, please finish the activity. I am sorry. I think Luis is not paying attention, or maybe Anthony, could you do the number eight, please? Yes, I can hear you. Okay, the number eight, please. Excellent. Yeah, my dear students, this is an extra practice for comparatives and superlatives. And finally, the letter B. Please complete the sentences so that they mean the same as the sentence in A. We did this activity the last Friday. Yeah, we did in the PowerPoint presentation. Anyway, you are going to remember here. Let's see if you remember. I want to see if you remember. It is 4 and 26. I check the activity in 4 minutes, please. I check the activity in 4 minutes.
Recording stopped.
Pay attention to the role. Mientras usted hace, tomo lista. Okay, Angulo Naomi. Briseño Pamela.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Brito Mateo.
Present, teacher.
Cadena Jorge. Cadena. Kaisa Lenin.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Cañizares.
Present, teacher.
Carrillo Jacob.
Present, teacher.
Cobo.
Daniel. Present, teacher.
Okay. Coraquilia Allison.
Present, teacher.
Cruz Jair. Domínguez Alexander.
Present, teacher.
Okay. García Alexis. Gonzaga Anthony.
Present, teacher.
Guamán Franklin.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Huasco Andy.
Present, teacher.
Guerra Jonathan.
Present, teacher.
Herrera Mario.
Present, teacher.
Thanks. Huaraca Carol.
Present, teacher.
Leiva Mateo.
Present, teacher.
Thanks. Okay. León, Diego.
Present, teacher.
Maña, Francisco. Thanks. Francisco.
Present, teacher.
Francisco.
Sí, yes? Teacher.
Okay. Males Kumara.
Present, teacher.
Malitasik Maritza.
Present, teacher.
Minaya Brian. No. Okay. Mosquera, Kevin.
Present teacher.
Okay. Pachacama, Alex.
Present teacher.
Okay. Paredes, Johan.
Present teacher.
Mr. Paredes, usted me dijo que le revise algo. ¿Cuál era su pedido? Disculpe, he olvidado, pero ahorita que veo su apellido me acordé.
Sí, que revise las notas que había subido a la BAC y me había puesto cero en la actividad de Cambridge, de la unidad 4 y 5, pero yo sí tengo hechas.
Ya voy a revisar otra vez. Si no me hace un acuerdito, porque como uno pasa al sistema, solamente están subidas en el ABAC, no hay problema. Si estuviera en el sistema, es complicado. ¿Ok?
Thank you, teacher.
Ya, Mr. Paredes. Thank you. Pastuña.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Pilco.
Present, teacher.
Luis. Reynoso. Yes, Reynoso Pamela.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Remache, Michelle.
Present, teacher.
Robles.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Rojas.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Rosales.
Present, teacher.
Sandoval.
Present, teacher.
Sarmiento. Oh my goodness, ¿qué pasa? Sarmiento, ¿no? Ok, Sarmiento, absent. Silva, yes. Subía.
Present, teacher.
Zipan. Tonato.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Zipan. Yes, thank you. Tonato.
I'm present, teacher.
¿Ya? Ah, Zambrano, Alexander. Zumba.
Present, teacher.
Yeah. Okay, my dear students, I finished.
¿Me puede poner en lista?
Yes.
¿Puede poner en lista?
Your name.
Minaya.
A mí también, teacher.
Your name.
García, Alexis García. Sí,
a mí igual.
Digan presente cuando les nombro, por favor.
Sí, le dije.
A mí no me nombró. Cruz, por favor.
García. Cruz. Creo que están durmiendo y cuando ya les avisan que estoy tomando la lista, ahí sí.
Y ahora a mí no me nombró.
¿Su apellido?
Silva.
Sí, sí, le puse.
Ah, ya, ok.
Sí, sí, ok. Y aquí dice Jair Gabriel Cruz. Ok, Mr. Cruz, ya le pongo.
Teacher, hoy hay actividad en el ABAC.
Por supuesto, una enorme. We have class until 5 o'clock, ok? Then you have to work in the ABAC activity. Ya. Yeah. Okay, my dear students, so let's check the activity. Remember, this is only a review of comparatives. I'm going to put you the answers. You see, wait, I have to record this.
Recording in progress.
Share the answers, please. You see, and you compare, please. This is for your book. Number two, I've never eaten a more delicious meal than this one. Okay, number three, I didn't expect the weather to be as hot as it was. Number four, she drives more slowly than I do. Number five, is anybody in your class as clever as, or you can also say cleverer than you? Number six. It says, I didn't have a good holiday. The hotel was worse than everything else. Number seven, you speak English better than I do. And finally, number eight, I am sorry, I can't come on Friday. It is busier than the other days, okay? Yeah, my dear students, this is all about grammar. We go back to the page number 72. Here we go. We finish this activity. We finish this activity. And here we are going to do this activity, please, because it helps to practice a little bit more the grammar structure. You are going to use these words, pay attention, the words cheap, fun, good for you, healthy, interesting, nice, spicy, sweet, tasty, to write sentences with this information. For example, look, the number one, we have dark chocolate, milk chocolate, white chocolate. Example, dark chocolate isn't as nice as white chocolate, okay? Now, here we have street food, comida de la calle, no? Food is expensive, food in expensive restaurants, and homemade food. You are going to choose any word from the box, and you are going to make, here says, make comparatives, superlatives, and as, could be negative or positive, adjective as, you decide, okay? It is 4:34, you have 6 minutes for doing the activity, and I check, work in your agendas, I don't know, or in a piece of paper, and then you read your examples. If you remember, you can say,
no.
Okay, guys. You have one example. You have one example, okay?
Teacher.
Ajá.
Tuve problemas con mi conexión y me dicen que ha tomado lista. No sé si me podría poner en lista, Sarmiento.
What is your name?
Sarmiento.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, teacher.
Don't stop working, please. Thank you. Okay, time for checking the activity. Cesar Tipan, please tell me this one. Street food, food in expensive restaurants, homemade food.
Street food is not healthier than that food in expensive restaurants.
You can say, Cesar, you can say street food isn't as healthy as food in expensive restaurants. That is better for your idea. Street food isn't as healthy as food in expensive restaurants, or maybe food homemade food. I am crazy. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Jose Antonio Subía, please. Japanese food, British food, Indian food.
Japanese food.
You have to compare or make superlatives with that information and the information.
Okay, I think Indian food is better than British food, but Japanese is the best.
Okay, your example is good, but remember you have to use these words. Good for you. Yeah, you are okay. Thank you. Alex Dominguez, please. Vegetarian food, meat dishes, fish dishes.
Perdón, teacher, no le escuché bien.
You have to do the example with vegetarian food, meat dishes, or fish dishes.
Sushi. Vegetarian food. Salad.
You are not paying attention, sir. Pero si estamos ya diciendo algunos ejemplos. A volunteer, please, for vegetarian food, meat dishes, fish dishes. Volunteers. Make comparative, tell me, please. Comparative or superlative? Thanks, do it.
Vegetarian food is healthy as meat dishes, as fish dishes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can say vegetarian food is as healthy as meat dishes and fish dishes. Okay, thank you. Good. Thanks, Miss Catherine. Number the next food from my country, food from other countries.
Food of my country is not as sweet as food from other countries.
Good. Food from my country is not as sweet. Okay, thanks, Miss. Good, your example. And I finish with the last. Mateo, please. Eating alone, eating with friends. Mateo Leiva, please. Hello, say something. Maybe he is not paying attention. Could you help me, please, with eating alone or eating with friends? Comparative or superlative?
Eating with friends is better than eating alone.
Excellent. Eating with friends is better than eating alone. Okay, my dear students, this is the end of this activity. Now we are going to read. We are going to do the reading activity, and then I suppose it is going to be 5. Then you are going to have the activity in the ABAC, okay? It says, look at the photo on the left. This is the picture. Look at this picture. This is, what country do you think is this? What country do you think is this?
China,
yes, because of the signs. Look, it says, wait a second. Look at the photo on the left. Which country do you think it is? You say it is China. Yes, look. Yeah. Okay. Read the blog, Hungry Adventures. which is the block. I think this is the block, or let's see if it is in the other page. Ah, here it is, hungry, adventures. Here you can see traveling and eating around the world. Look at the pictures, picture A, B, C, and D. You have four pictures, I suppose, in the, yeah? A, look, hungry adventures. We are going to read. Here says, have you eaten? Okay, read, please. You are going to read in silent, please, in your books. I am not going to read because I have problems with my sword today. Yeah, so read, please, because you have to read. If you don't read, you are not going to be able to do this activity. Read the block again and find the descriptions, please, for these dishes. Chicken satay, murigonto, sendol, and thosai. You have to read to find the answers. Read, please, in your books. Have you eaten? I am going to read in silent, and when I finish, I move to the next, okay? I finish this, go to the next page, guys. Read this, please. Walker centers, street food, but not on the streets. Read, please. Okay, finally, the last, please, my dear students, read Little India, Big Appetite. Okay, so now that you have finished reading this, you have to tell me, please, What picture is for this dish, chicken satay? Picture A, B, C, or D?
Letter C.
Letter C, okay.
Letter B.
Or letter B, okay. I write, we check in a moment. And number two, what picture is it for Murigoncho?
Letter C.
Okay, we check in a moment. And finally, what picture is it for Sendol?
Letter B.
Letter B.
B.
Letter B or D?
B.
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 Okay, so in the number one is D. Yeah. Number four, Tosai.
Letter A.
Yeah, we are going to check your answers. Yes, 1D, 2C, perfect. Now my question is, check please, here we have the dish number one. This one, no, no, it wasn't, sorry. Dish number one, letter A. Dish, letter B, C, and D. My question is, which dish would you like to try? For example, in my case, I would like to try the letter D. And you? Which dish would you like to try? Maybe the letter C, letter B, or letter A? Which dish do you think is the most delicious?
The letter A, teacher.
Letter A, yeah, it looks nice, but I prefer the letter. The letter I said, I think it was the letter D. Yeah, okay, my dear students, I think, what else? Let me see. Please, you are going to have a homework, okay? You have to do this. You are going to read, again, this, please. You are going to read this part. You have to read Hungry Adventures again, and you are going to answer the question number one, two, three, four, five, and six. It says, what do habits slow that the people in Singapore love food? What do habits show you that people in Singapore love food? Check, please, you have to read here this part, and you are going to answer the question. Question number two. What did the blog writer eat in her fish head curry? Question number three, why can you buy food on the street in Singapore? Question number four, why didn't she have soup tulak in the Golden Mile Food Center? Number five, why didn't she eat anything in the Arab Quarter? And number six, which area of Singapore did she not go to? You have to read all the information to answer these questions. And also, please, tomorrow we are going to practice speaking in the first hour, because in the second hour you are going to take the test. Okay, so it says you are going to talk about a special meal for you. Okay, you are going to make notes about one of these meals, and you are going to use these ideas. For example, the most special meal that you have ever made, the most delicious meal that you have ever eaten, and a meal you will never forget. Yeah, I'm going to ask you questions where, for example, where did you eat? When did you eat? Who did you eat with? What ingredients that did your favorite food had? How was the food cooked? How did the food taste? How did the food smell? And what was the color of the food? Yeah, this is for tomorrow. Let me see if we have time to do something else. No, no more. We are going to finish the class here. Please, I'm going to share the ABAC. Wait a moment. If you have questions, tell me, please.
Teacher, la actividad está como que se fuera a cerrar a las 5 de la tarde.
Ya reviso. Okay. I'm gonna check it now. Maybe I didn't write the correct date. A ver. Remember, tomorrow is the test unit number 6, because this unit we are going to cover only the unit number 6. Yeah. Grammar and vocabulary. It says this will not be available until June 15, 5 p.m. Ah, yes. Yes, yes, I'm going to change. Okay. Yeah, so you have to do it in a minute. You have to wait 1 minute, guys, and you start the activity. If you don't have any other questions, just wait for a minute, and then you do the test. Not the test, the activity, okay? Don't forget, you finish the activity and you are free to leave the class, okay? The activity is ready. The activity is ready, okay?